We really appreciate all of you all coming out today. This is a great day in Lowndes County and BOPRA with the new ribbon cutting of our new Naylor Community Center. And this has been a while. We've been trying to work on this project and finally get it here. So it is happening today. We already have it rented out this weekend, so for the first time. So it's really a neat thing. But what I wanted to just first mention to you all is I want to introduce our chairman of the county commissioners, Mr. Bill Slaughter, and then he's going to make some comments, and then I'll come back and make some other comments and some more folks as well. So, again, thank you all for being here. Chairman.
Thank you, Mr. Page. First, I want to welcome everybody to this event today. This facility here has been a long time planning and a lot of effort by a lot of folks. When I first took office, 6 years ago, one of the first things that I had heard out of fellow commissioner Miss Evans was, I got to talk to you about the Naylor Community Center. And so that she's had that in her heart for a long, long time. And so Miss Evans, here we are. We're ready to go. So again, welcome everybody. I'd like to introduce some of the commissioners that are here. Of course, we have Miss Evans, we have Mr. Weisenbaker, Mr. Griner, Mr. Ornstein is here with us. Also, we have our county manager, Mr. Joe Pritchard, and some of his staff members here as well. And folks, I can tell you, projects like this does not just happen. It takes a lot of people working together as a team to be able to bring a project like this to fruition. And certainly, Lowndes County staff is a huge part of doing that. So they've done a fantastic job with this facility. This is a facility that will serve the Naylor community for a long, long time. And so we're very proud of it. We hope the folks here in Naylor are as equally as proud of it. And we look forward to being able to use it for a lot of different events in this community. It is way, way better than the little block building over there that was used for so many years. And so now we've got a great facility here. At this time, I'd like to also call on one of the driving forces in this whole project as well to make this come to fruition is Mr. J.C. Riley. I'd like to call on Mr. Riley to provide the invocation for us. Mr. Riley.
Beautiful place. Good job.
Absolutely. All right, this time then, I'll be glad to turn it back over to Mr. Page, and if you've got some comments, because that is the process. Lowndes County and your Sploss Kennys have built this facility, and we will now turn this facility over to the Valdosta Lowndes Park and Recreation Authority for them to operate with this community. So again, it's in good hands as it continues on.
Thank you, Mayor. Just, before I just mention, you mentioned this along the many years. Well, about 5 years ago, the VLPRA had to do a system-wide comprehensive master plan. We're required by legislation that every 5 years we do a master plan. And one of the things in the master plan that was one of the highlighted things of need was a new community center in the neighborhood community. And I'll tell you, we had 7 public meetings, and it was standing room only in the old building. And we had probably close to, we had more people attend that public meeting for our master plan than any of the others. And it was actually during the middle of the day, from like 12 to 1 o'clock. So I will tell you, your voices were heard within the master plan. It was a Sploss project. And we are going to be redoing another 5-year master plan next year. So we will definitely be having another, this will be an area here, a community meeting here for that as well. But we're so grateful and thankful for Lowndes County, the hard work that their entire administration team, the engineers and all the builders working this together to get us such a beautiful facility at this park. And it will be very well utilizing our first scheduled renter is Mr. Riley. So this coming weekend and his family for a graduation party. And so it's already being rented out quite a bit in the next several months. So that just goes to show you that there is a true need for this facility, and a lot of hard work and a lot of teammates, teammates working together to make it happen. And we're so excited to be able to manage this facility now after its completion. So thank you, and again, thank you all for being here today. Really appreciate it.
George,
would
you tell everybody what the price of this is? People are calling me, and I figured I'd let you tell them what the price of it is to rent.
Oh, to rent the facility,
right.
It is for, it's a two-hour camera. It is $665 an hour, so basically you're looking at $140 to rent the facility for 2 hours. And that covers, we'll have a staff member here that will be, anytime, our policy is anytime a facility is rented, we have to have a monitor. So that covers that and everything, but basically it's $130 for 2 hours, and it costs the same at this facility as any of the other facilities that we have in our system. So not one's higher than the other, all for the same price.
Okay, are the other deposits?
I'm sorry? Yes, ma'am, you have to put a deposit down, $100 deposit. However, you get that back if everything's clean, if you do not damage anything. From that standpoint, and we normally have that deposit once the event is over, we normally have that deposit back within the week. But again, that's the same for this facility as any of the other facilities. But we have to have, the big thing is we have to have a staff member, a part-time staff member, anytime we rent these facilities to make sure that they're taken care of and well kept and clean after they live in. If you'll see any of our other facilities, they do an amazing job making sure that things are kept up.
Phil, if you could explain to you about Shelton baseball field. Shelton baseball field. I operate Tulsa.
Yes. If you want to rent, if the family wants to rent a shelter for a picnic or family reunion or what have you, that is $40 to rent for the shelter for that. So you're looking at it. $40 fee for the shelter rental, and that will guarantee you the rental. We'll make sure that you have that, you get a receipt. And if you show up and somebody's there, you have that with you, we have it reserved for the parks to rent. So we will be doing the shelter rentals here as well.
And the spring
yeah.
building.
Yeah. 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 And we're going to be refurbishing that this year.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. If you rent the building, that you do have to rent the shelter separate. If you rent the building for a day, would you have to do the shelter separate or would they?
If you rent the building, as far as, if you rent the building and someone else wants to rent the shelter for Bertha, they can do both. So if you rent the building, you don't automatically get all the shelters with it. It's separate. But if, you know, from that standpoint, because if there's somebody that rents the shelter, you know, that would be, you know, for another, you know, someone else rents that.
All fields, actually, for anyone that wants to.
All fields, it's an open field, yeah, there's, yeah, that's an open, that's what we call an open recreation area, open play, there's no field around, you know, for ball fields.
Okay, at this time, just we'll move on. I do want to quickly acknowledge Mr. Glenn Gregory and his firm for his architectural design on the building, as well as the contractor Kellerman Construction. But as you can see, they've done a fantastic job in the building. So when you get an opportunity, give those gentlemen a big thank you for their efforts in doing this. So at this time, are we ready to cut a ribbon?
Yes, sir. We're going to step out front to do that. Make sure we'll just